4's Paul Van Osdahl is crunching the numbers. He's live in the newsroom tonight. Paul.
Well, Andrew, the most recent report shows the Rivers Casino made less money per slot machine than any other casino in the state. Right now, the casino is on pace to make only half of what its owners projected in the first year. So they're upping the ante with more giveaways to lure in customers. You'll always find someone playing slots at the Rivers Casino, but far too many of the 3,000 slot machines are not being played by anybody. In August, when the casino opened, its owners projected a first-year take of $400 million, but it's made just $34 million in the first 2 months. That projects out to $203 million for the year, only half of the estimated haul. For the week ending October 4th, Philadelphia Park Casino earned $350 per slot machine. Presque Isle earned $233, the Meadows $194, and the Rivers just $161 per slot machine, the lowest total of any Pennsylvania casino.
It's been consistently low compared to other casinos. Is there any reason for that?
And that is what we're actually trying to figure out.
So over the course of the first 2 months, I think revenues are lower than we expected them to be. That is of concern in a lot of ways.
That's because the city and Allegheny County are relying on casino money for lots of projects. Over 5 years, a projected $49 million for the city and $49 million for the county. Add to that $7.5 million per year to fund the new Penguins Arena and another $6 million for community development projects on the North Side and Hill District. Now the casino is counting on the Steelers and the Pitt Panthers to help generate more customers and more revenue.
When the Steelers or the Panthers score a touchdown, it is $5 free play throughout the house.
They're even giving away a car every week. It's about time, says the mayor.
They took for granted that people were simply just going to come because it was there. Maybe that's not the case. Maybe they need to do more marketing like the other casinos do.
Casino officials are also hoping for table games to draw more customers. Table game legislation is still being debated in Harrisburg. Earlier this month, the owners of the casino suffered a drop in their bond rating because of the lower-than-expected revenues. Paul Van Osdahl, Channel 4 Action News.